Good morning, YouTube. How are you guys doing today? It's me, your Texas favorite trucker. And I am currently in Mississippi. I just left the Spaceway Travel Center. I'll tell you why I ended up there in just a minute. But I didn't get very good sleep last night. So I woke up about 2 hours before my 10-hour break was over with, and I decided, you know, that since I've had such a bad string of luck lately, that all I want to do is just go in and get some breakfast, which I normally don't do at truck stops. Occasionally, every now and again, there's maybe 4 or 5 truck stops that I really enjoy getting breakfast at. Of course, the Spaceway is a, you know, one of those kind of off-brand truck stops. You know, you go to Pilot, you get Subway, and, you know, you go to Flying J, you get Denny's, you know, you go to Love's, you get Arby's and Carl Jr., occasionally a McDonald's thrown in. And honestly, I'm sick to death of that crap. I wish they'd change it up and do something different, you know. But this place just had a restaurant, so I decided, what the hell, I'm going to get me some biscuits and gravy or something. So I went in there and I saw they had omelets, and I'm kind of a fanatic for omelets. So I went in there and bought the omelet, $8.99. And they brought me out this freaking omelet, big enough to feed Paul Bunyan. You know, this damn thing took up the entire plate. And then another entire plate full of hash browns. And I couldn't eat it all. I only ate about a third of it. The rest of it I put in a go box that's in my refrigerator. I'll heat it up later on and eat it for dinner or something. Anyway, last night I was cruising. And I had about 2 hours left to go. And then I was going to finish bringing this load in to the distributor here in Albany. And it's a glass load that's going to be end up at Miller, but we take it to this place behind Miller, and they deal with it, kind of the same deal as Castle and Cook in Fort Worth. And so anyway, running down the road, I had another blowout on my trailer, my third blowout on this truck in the last couple months, the second one in 2 weeks. So I had a blowout on the trailer, I pulled off the side of the road, pulled over before the tires shredded, so I didn't throw any debris anywhere. I called Premier Care and had them come out and fix it. Fell asleep while I was waiting on them, and he came and woke me up after he fixed it, and then I headed on. Well, you know, it took them 4 hours to get there and get it fixed, so 3.5 hours, something like that. So I lost a lot of drive time last night, which put me behind the schedule on the load. I wasn't able to get there on time. First load I've had late yet. And so, you know, I went looking for parking. I stopped at a rest area. Wasn't nothing happening. I could barely fit through there to get out the other side. Spaceway truck stop was the next one in the route. I was almost out of time. I mean, I still had an hour I could have searched for places, but, you know, I'm in that time limit. It's time to find something to pull over at. Finding the parking isn't easy. And I pulled into Spaceway not expecting to find anything. And sure enough, you know, there I was with a parking spot right off the bat, you know. And so I went ahead and I parked. Didn't have any problem finding a place to put it. Huge, huge parking space. And the way it's set up is that, you know, there's a lot of space for you to park, you know, to even make parking spots, you know, that aren't technically parking spots without congesting things. So I found a place to park this morning. I went in to get breakfast. I had to send a message to dispatch telling them that I'm not going to be able to make this load on time because of the blown tire again. Now that's going to become a pretty common occurrence as it heats up. You know, once the heat gets going, you know, treads start throwing, expect to have quite a few more of these blowouts before the summer's over. But, you know, I kicked back in the truck stop until I could get going. And then this morning, I get up and I do my pre-trip about 2 hours before it's time to leave, you know, just because I'm awake and have nothing better to do. So I get up and go do my pre-trip, and the tire they replaced last night is low on air. You know, I was sitting in an angle, so I was thinking, well, maybe just all the pressure's on that tire and it just looks low. You know, it's not really low. Surely it can't be low on it. And they just fixed it and replaced it last night. So, of course, I look at the tire right in front of it, and it ain't low. It ain't close to me. I walk around to the other side, and I look at that tire, and it ain't low. And I'm like, man. So I got to get a tire gauge and put a tire gauge on it. Sure enough, it's at 50 PSI, and we're supposed to be running about 100 to 110 PSI. So, yeah, it was low. I don't know if it's leaking air or if the technician last night was just lazy and didn't want to fill it up. I don't know. But it's definitely low. So I filled it up, filled the tire up, sat around waiting for the last 10, 15 minutes to time out on my brake so that I could let get on the road. Now I'm on the road headed up out. I got about 5 hours, 36 minutes to go. So all of that was to say this right here. This is two times that a technician or a mechanic, whatever you want to call them, has done something to my truck and it not be correct. Okay, the first time, you'll recall, if I posted this video, I remember, but I was in Cartersville and I got a B service done. And they didn't put the oil filler cap back on the engine when they filled up my oil, and I didn't check it when I left. And it blew two gallons of oil all over the inside of the engine compartment. The second time was last night. They fixed this tire, repaired the tire, and hit a 50 pounds short on air. Now, had I not gone back and just double checked everything this morning, and I do a pre-trip every morning usually. And I say usually because I did not do the engine part of the pre-trip after Cartersville because I hadn't gone anywhere and they had just fixed my engine on B service. I assumed, and wrongfully assumed, that there was nothing for me to check. Everything was good because they were supposed to check everything and make sure that everything was good. I was wrong for not doing the check, and I've done the check every morning since. But I go around and I check everything. And your tires, are pretty important to check because if you have low air pressure in your tires, you can blow a tire. All right? Well, it's one of the reasons why tires blow is because the air pressure's not right in. So, anytime that you get a new trailer, or every morning before you go out on your trip, you want to check your tire pressure. Make sure that they're right. A lot of times you can do that just by looking at it. You don't really necessarily have to put a tire gauge on it. You can look at a tire and tell if it's low. Especially if you're under a load. So normally that's sufficient. Just drive around and walk around and look at it. If it looks low, put a tire gauge on it and find out. This one, there was no doubt about it. It was definitely low. But it wasn't, but it was definitely low. So you check your stuff every day before you roll out, because if you roll out and you don't check it, you're subject to be on the side of the road getting the tire replaced. Right? Now checking it doesn't mean that you're not going to be on the side of the road, but you're going to check it anyway. So anyway, that's the update. That's where we're at. We're headed to Albany. We're dropping the Albany yard. And I think I may have done a video. No, I haven't. I don't think I've done a video on the Albany yard yet. So I'll flip the camera around when we come in there and let you see it. It's a lot like the Weeds courtyard. So once you see it, we'll roll up in there. All right. Till then, peace out.